Hey everyone, it's Gart and I'm back with an exciting new video about going to enhance your texturing and surfacing journey. Today we are diving headfirst into the cutting edge world of fabric creation with AI. I present to you VMod Fabricator, the ultimate text-to-texture generative AI for crafting stunning PBR fabric materials. In this tutorial, I will guide you through the magic of Fabricator, showcasing how with just a few words, you can conjure up original, seamless, high-resolution 3D fabric textures with PBR maps, all thanks to the power of AI. Whether you're a texture lover, eager to explore new frontiers, or a seasoned pro seeking efficiency in your workflow, this tutorial is your gateway to unlimited creative exploration. Now get ready to jump with me into the world of creating PBR fabric materials with AI. So get relaxed, grab a coffee or a cup of tea, and let's roll the intro! Imagine VMod Fabricator as your trusty sidekick in this wild digital world. It's not just a tool, it's like having a creative journey buddy by your side. Now, what makes Fabricator so cool is this AI image generation thing. Picture it as Midjourney equivalent, but specialized in fabric texture generations. You can throw a single prompt, like telling your buddy, hey, let's make something cool, and boom, Fabricator turns it into these amazing, super detailed fabric textures. Okay, let's start right now. Some quick pop-up windows to explain the basics on how to use it. Here we go, the main interface. On the left, you have the main panel, where you can choose between two generation styles. The first lets you convert a photo of a fabric sample into a PBR material. The second, which we are exploring today, generates fabric textures using AI with a text prompt. Let's dive into the text prompt options. You can choose from three quick choices: patterns, characteristics, and colors. Alternatively, you can describe the texture using specific keywords in the input field below. Let's click on patterns. There's a variety of art styles to choose from. Now let's go for a classic solid color, black and light gray. Next, the characteristics. We have a lot of interesting options. Let's go with distressed. We can also add rough, for example. Now we can use the adjust feature to emphasize certain elements in our text prompt. Clicking plus next to a word or phrase will amplify its effect, while minus will reduce it. Okay, let's tweak the values here. You can even incorporate a negative prompt to exclude particular elements from the generated fabric texture, such as distort or any visual element you don't want to appear in the textures. Now let's choose our fabric type. Let's choose leather. Next, you can use a reference image to adjust the result if prompts aren't giving you the results you want, or if you have a specific reference. Then, last but not least, you can choose how many textures will be generated on the fly. Let's go with 4. Below, as you can see, we have the estimate time and cost for this image generation. Let's generate now. Done. Okay, let's take a look at them. I will go with this one. Seems pretty interesting. In this part now, we will create a seamless texture based on the area selected. So make it seamless and let's wait 1 minute again. Wow, pretty neat result. Let's click on next. Now time to upscale the texture. Let's choose 4K and upscale texture. Now it's time to generate our PBR maps based on the texture generated before. Let's add also a metallic texture to the selection and click on generate PBR maps button. Boom, done. Pretty interesting. We can control the different output maps below. We can also change the preview model on the left panel. We can also tweak various preview options like switch on and off the background visibility, change the light intensity, and change the HDRI map. We can also tweak the scale of the texture set and edit the map's weight properties. Really, really nice. Okay, let's try with another idea. So create new texture. Once again, let's choose a pattern. Let's go with color. Let's pick River Blue. And for characteristics, glittered, perforated, and glossy. For the fabric type, let's pick Denim. Now, this time, let's input a reference image. Let's adjust some weights on the text prompt. Oh, this one is pretty interesting. Let's pick this one. Now let's do the next processes quickly, as it's the same as before. And boom, the result. Pretty interesting. What are your thoughts? Do you believe it will revolutionize digital fabric texture creation, or it's just a great tool for researching ideas? Share your thoughts in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.